with you, but this is not the way to deal with it!
Look at me, I'm not your enemy.
We are at an impasse until we can mutually respect each other as doctor and patient.
This is Brett Bauer, the writer and director of VENOM. Join us for a special behind-the-scenes look at our initial read-through and early rehearsal footage, but first, an in-depth look at the auditions and the casting process for the film.
Can you tell me your name and the city that you live in?
We live in Texas.
You live in Texas? What part? Is it Dallas?
No, Texas.
You said you just turned 4? Can I tell you a story? This is a story about a little girl. She's about your age. Can you tell me how you might feel if one day somebody that you loved and was very special to you, if all of a sudden you didn't know where they were and you couldn't find them? How would that make you feel?
Very sad.
You obviously need help, but that's not enough. You have to want help. And until you do, my job is useless. I don't need you to find me.
Can you show me on your face how you look when you get really sad and really scared? What if you were the little girl in the story?
I'm just going to talk you through something. I want you to think about a little girl. She's about 4 or 5 years old. She's your daughter. Absolute joy of your life. Just one of those just makes your heart melt. She just climbs into your lap and just makes everything in the world seem better, no matter what you're going through. And one day she's playing outside and nobody's watching her very carefully, and somebody takes her away. Whatever you would want to say to this person, say it to me.
You can never take back what you did. And I will pay the price for the rest of my life because of what you did to me. How could anybody in this world be so evil? What were you thinking?
Just keep your eyes closed. I want you to stay right there in that moment. But switch gears. You are now the man that took this little girl. And you are sitting across from this little girl's father. And you know that he knows exactly what you did. And if you were the man who took this girl away, what could you possibly say to this girl's father who's sitting right across from you in the same room?
If you want it to happen, you can make it happen. It doesn't matter who. Doesn't matter where. All that matters is that I wanted it at that time.
Do you feel the slightest bit of remorse?
Was an experience that I wanted to have, and it was nothing personal, but it had to happen.
Would you do it again?
If I wanted to.
Will you do it again?
Probably.
just going to be in my memory.
Because only God in heaven can make a butterfly.
That's pretty. Good job. Thank you so much, Tiffany. Can I shake your hand? Thank you for auditioning for my movie. I am very impressed.
All right, I won't put you through this anymore.
See, happy thoughts.
Fun audition.
Happy thoughts.
Nice to meet you, Brett.
Send in the clowns. Where are the clowns?
I don't know what's wrong with you, but this is not the way to deal with it. Look, I don't know what's wrong with you. Look, I don't know what's wrong with you. I don't know what... Oh, sorry.
I'm at... Is this the audition?
And here is my favorite scene from the movie. Cast and crew did a phenomenal job.
You're becoming obsessed.
All right, let's discuss your childhood.
Put the clipboard down.
Why?
It makes me uncomfortable. Just put it down.
Why does it make you uncomfortable?
Why do you ask so many stupid questions?
I'm sorry.
And quit apologizing!
I'm sorry.
When you're holding that thing, it's like you're not really talking to me.
I'm just trying to help you.
Trying to help me? You're not trying to help. You don't care anything about me. I'm just another specimen for you to study. You sit there with this pretentious look on your face, taking notes on everything I say.
Just something that makes you... Now just calm down.
I don't want to calm down.
You're going to do something you regret.
I've done plenty.
Look.
You think I wanted to be this
way?
I didn't.
Any sense.
She's not the only victim. I'm a victim.
Who are you talking about? Your mother?
What's that supposed to mean?
I only meant...
So typical. Misplaced anger and aggression.
I have had enough of your destructive behavior.
I don't need you to define me. You think you're so superior because of what you do for a living. You look for any opportunity to shove your profession in other people's faces. It's nothing but a sick game that allows you to feed the world your so-called knowledge. Well, your knowledge isn't good enough. You only want to control people. I know you don't believe that, but it's true. The control, the power you desire over people is sickening! Who do you think you are, Philip? I don't need you to define me.
Join us for the next episode as we look at our table read and the first rehearsals for the film.